If you're thinking about drilling a well, you need to do some basic groundwork first. And the first thing you need to do is you need to go out and find if it's even legal where you are. A lot of places have made it illegal, or there's a lot of restrictions that you have to comply with, and so you need to know what those are before you even start buying materials to start drilling your well. So to do this, go to your local courthouse, tell them you're looking to drill your own well on your own property. I emphasize that because the rules to drill a well for someone else are often different from the rules to drill a well for yourself on your own land. So go there, tell them you want to drill your own well on your own property. What are the rules? They'll tell you. There'll maybe a long sheet of rules and maybe nothing at all. Usually you'll have something you'll have to comply with. Some places you'll have to be inspected by an inspector. Some places the inspector will have to watch your case. Sometimes you'll have to be there for the entire drilling process. And sometimes it's just a weird set of rules you have to follow. You may have to be 18 feet or 50 feet or 10 feet or whatever down. Have an 18-inch hole or an 8-inch hole or a 5-inch hole. So just find out what is in your area. It's going to be different everywhere. The next question is, what kind of soil are you going to have to drill through? Because what kind of soil you have to drill through is going to determine what kind of drill you use, how much time it's going to take, and that kind of thing. So while you're at the courthouse, go there and ask for the well logs in your area. Well logs are required to be kept by well drillers so that you have a record of all the wells that have been drilled in a local area. You can request these, a public record, and they'll give you an idea of whether they hit rock or water at certain levels or deeper. They'll give you an idea of when they hit sand. So it's a good source of information. Now, these records are not gospel because they have no real reason to have them be perfect. All they really care about is getting something written down. So they make stuff up sometimes, but it's an idea, it's a place to start. Now, the other thing you're going to need to know is how deep you're going to have to drill. You can find out some of this from the well logs, but there again, they don't really know where the water is when they start drilling down there. They say hit water at a certain depth, but they really can't tell. They sound like they can, but they really can't. When you have a soil that has some mud in it, soil that has a good source of water, and soil that's just a solid rock, it feels a little bit different when you're drilling, but not that much. Most well drillers are interested in getting a couple hundred feet down where they have tons of water, hit the aquifer, and get out of there. Get paid by the foot. So when you're trying to drill your own well, you don't need to go that deep. And so you may not need to go as deep as they go. But again, this is a place to start. The better way of finding how deep you need to drill is to find local people, neighbors that have wells in your area. Hopefully you'll have a neighbor or two that will let you come over and drop a float down their well with a string attached, so you'll be able to measure how far it is to the first water you hit. See, well drillers, they're not interested in the first water. They want to get down deep to the aquifer. So they're wanting to get a lot of extra water down there from a certain level. And again, they're getting paid by the foot, so it's to their advantage to go deeper even if they don't need to. So while you're drilling your well, you may run across very good water at 50 feet down. You don't have to go to 200 feet. Just because your neighbor did doesn't mean you do. What matters is where the first water level is. So if you drop a float in someone's well and it bounces at, say, 45 feet, that's where you're going to hit water, somewhere in that neighborhood. Now, if your neighbor's up on a hill and you're down in the valley, you're probably going to be shallower than they are. On the other hand, if they're down in the valley and you're up on the hill, then you're going to be deeper than that. But again, it's a place to start. You'll never know until you actually do it, but it's a place to start, and so you'll be able to figure out what you need to, what your ballpark is. Next, you need to find out how much water you really need. Your average household and your average small farm is going to be just fine with a 4-inch well. If you get deep enough down so you have a good enough water supply, you don't need anything bigger than that, and that's by far the easiest one to drill or have drilled. You start going bigger to a 6-inch casing, and you'll get a little bit more water standing in the well, but you won't really get any more water coming in. In other words, you have a column of water in your well at all times. Let's say you hit water at 45 feet and you drill down to 65 feet. So you have a 20-foot column of water in your well. When you kick your pump on, it's going to start sucking that water down out of the column before it starts pulling in water from the outside edge. So the bigger your pipe is, the larger that standing column of water is, and the larger your drawdown capability is. That's what the term is. When you have a bigger casing, you get more drawdown, but you don't get any more coming in from outside. So once you draw down that 20 or 30 gallons that's actually being held in the well at all times, a bigger casing doesn't really help you pull in more water from the outside very much. So a 4-inch well will pull in almost as much water as a 6-inch well. It'll just allow you to put a bigger pump in. So it's a lot easier to go another 20 feet deeper and get more water in your well than it is to make a bigger casing usually. So again, find out what your needs are. If you're typical, if you have a house and a small farm, maybe just a little bit of irrigation on the side, you don't need more than a 4-inch well. If you're going to do it much bigger than that, then yeah, you should probably go for the 6-inch or going 2 or 3 wells. Finally, the question is, how much time and how much money do you have? Because this is going to determine how you get your well drilled. If you have money coming out your ears and no time, then just go to the Yellow Pages, call a local well driller, say, hey, I'll give you 10 grand, come drill me a well, call it done, and that's the day. If, however, you're like most of us and you don't have that kind of money to throw around, then you need to decide how much money you have and how much time you have. If you have some time to invest, some labor to invest, and you don't have a whole lot of money, and your well is going to be very shallow, like maybe 30 feet or so, then you can try any of the methods I've outlined in my other videos about drilling a hand-dug well, driving a well point, or jetting a well. And those work fine. If you're going to go a little bit deeper than that, then you should consider the well drill that I sell on my website, which you can see at howtodrillawell.com. And it allows you to go up to 200 feet deep and is a lot less expense than having a professional do it for you. If you're having to drill through a lot of rock, I would not recommend my system. I'd recommend one of the auger kind, like the hydrodrill or deep rock systems. But these are the questions that you need to ask yourself before you start drilling, before you spend any money. Is it legal? How deep do I have to go? What kind of soil will I be drilling through? How much water do I need? And how much time and how much money can I afford to invest in this? That'll help you make your decision.